guys, what is going on? Aaron here from NXT Zombies coming at you with some more Black Ops 2 information, at least supposed information that has once again been circulating around the internet, and I'm not too sure if this is confirmed information or false information. And to be honest, it does sound pretty damn real to me, and according to a lot of sources, this is real information, it is multiplayer information, and let me know in the comment section below what you guys actually think about this, because I'm interested to know as well. So before I get into this video, just want to let you know to follow me on Twitter for live streams and other cool stuff, so definitely do that, link to the Twitter in the description below. And if you enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't done so already. So anyways guys, let's get started. Multiplayer, you can now make a class based on how much equipment you have rather than having to choose stuff you don't ever use. For example, it is possible for you to have 6 perks if you choose not to carry a primary or secondary weapon. You'll have just a knife. If you choose to pick a primary gun, it'll say that you need to replace one of those perks. And if you don't like any of the perks, you can add more features and attachments to your primary or secondary weapon. And those are some cool features that they would be adding, and I definitely like that. That's definitely a step up from previous Call of Duty games and stuff that'll, you know, change the game in ways that we haven't seen before. And personally, I think that's a great way to move the franchise. If you're going to take it that way, that adds a lot more features, a lot more, you know, game styles, a lot more game, you know, play ability. You know, it changes players, it changes player types, and it's a great way to go. Definitely, if they are going to do that, that's a smart way. And we did see that, you know, we did see some of that in the trailer before. We saw the actual class setups, the running guns, shotgun Sark, and the other two. I forget the names of the other two. I know the second one was a sniper and whatever, but that's not too important. Moving forward, boys and girls, apparently there's going to be a live streaming feature in theater mode. I thought that was cool. You know, that's something you can do. You can now live stream Black Ops 2, and this sounds a little fake, but if it is true, it's definitely going to be a step up from the theater mode we had in Modern Warfare 3, which was a step down for the Black Ops 1 for some reason. But if this live streaming feature is true, that will definitely be a big benefit for a lot of people that just want to stream their gameplay on the internet. And dedicated servers are returning. Thank Jesus for this. So you won't have to worry about host migrations or when someone leaves a match. So that's nothing to worry about, guys. That'll be great. Dedicated servers are back. I'm not going to go through the weapons. If you want to see the weapons that are confirmed, link to that in the description below. Oh, there's an article there. Take a look at it. It's got a lot more information. It's got single player and zombies too. I actually did upload a zombies video yesterday, so if you want to see that, hit that button right on top of the video and go check out our previous videos. It should be 2 or 3 videos ago, so definitely check that out. And some of the multiplayer maps, we got Cargo. It's a Singapore shipping yard. We got Aftermath, the ruins of Los Angeles, Hijacked, a map that takes place on a yacht, the slums in Panama, drone, power plant, nightclub, overflow, carrier, turbine. The one map that really catches my eye is nightclub. You get to play through a nightclub from the Al Jinan single player campaign. I have no idea how to pronounce Al Jinan. I don't know what the hell that is. But you actually play in a nightclub. That's a really cool map. If they did add that, it's probably going to be a small type map, you know, like a nuke town or scrapyard style map. And that's awesome. I definitely want to see that if that is a real map. Praying it is. Please be real information. No, Mr. Superman, no home. And they also go over the grenades and killstreaks and stuff. But honestly, if you want to take a look at that stuff, definitely check out this article. It's in-depth and all of it's there. And I don't really want to leak too much information. You should definitely check that out. Sorry. But the one thing that really caught my eye were the perks, because they're using a lot of Black Ops perks like Ghost and Cold-Blooded. Like, are you fucking... Why would they put that back into a game that they guaranteed it would never return? That's something that gives me this kind of, you know, hunch that this article is fake. And if it is fake, you know, that's a good thing, because we're not going to get Ghost, we're not going to get Cold-Blooded, and that's what I personally believe. I hate those fucking perks, and if they do return, I'm going to throw Call of Duty Black Ops 2 out the fucking window. No, I'm just kidding. I love zombies too much. So anyways, guys, let me know what you think about this information. Definitely check out that article in the description below. And if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. So thank you, and be sure to follow us on Twitter. Peace.